It was an awesome season last year.
It was fun. Yeah, thank you. It was a very fun season, yeah.
It's amazing how in love he is and what he'll do in order to protect his family. It's just,
yeah, they've certainly found the mojo in their marriage. They got mm-hmm. that back mm-hmm. in season two, and you get the continuation of that in season three, and the family unit being closer than ever. So we're going to see some more of that this season for sure. But life within the show, with this clone crazy sestrahood going on, it's very hard to get back to normal, which is all Alison and Donnie want. So, you know, that's a very large part of their struggle this season. But they still got the love.
Yeah.
That's important. Gotta have the love.
And do they still have the store?
Bubbles is still around.
Okay.
It's a legitimate business.
Okay.
Last season, Bubbles was a pill front.
Right.
And then everything kind of blew up in our face, and there's the election going on. Donnie almost got his nose cut off in a paper mm-hmm. cutter by the Portuguese mafia. You know, that old... Yeah, that happens.
Yeah.
So, they just want to be normal. Everything to be legit.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not that happens, that's another story. But yeah, it's going to be a very exciting season in the suburbs.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
So he's going to be a politician's husband.
He'll be the first lady.
Yeah, he'll be the first, yeah.
Donnie Hendricks' first lady, yeah.
And it looks like we're being teased in the trailers that they're trying to get pregnant.
Well, there's so many interesting angles to that. Of course, they've never had children themselves, and they adopted their kids, who they love like they are their own. But there's a lot of fun conspiracy theory unraveling this season, and there's a lot of questions and answers that people are looking for that happened this season, and that kind of ties into all of that.
So they're trying to get back to normal. How is that going to affect their relationship with the sisters? Are they going to try to distance themselves from them?
That's a good question. Yeah, Alison has always been pretty separate from the sestrahood, because she's always wanted to keep her family safe and out of all the craziness, because, yeah, there's murders going on and deaths, and of course, we've had our own spate of murders between the two of us, Alison and Donnie, in the suburbs, so trying to get that quiet suburban life back is definitely going to be difficult. There's no escaping the sisterhood, nor does she want to. She really cares about her sisters quite a lot. But it's up to Donnie and her to really try and keep that family separate. And of course, we have Helena living with us now.
Mm-hmm.
And she is a crazy roommate. And she's a ravenous pregnant lady who can sometimes fly off the handle. So definitely keeping people safe is a challenge in the suburbs.
Are you having fun playing that relationship between the two of them?
So much. Between Alison and Donnie, or Donnie and Helena?
Donnie and Helena.
So much. I love working with Helena. She's such a wild card, and Tat is so much fun to work with in any clone getup. But with Helena, Tat and I like to improv quite a bit, and
mm-hmm.
improving with Helena leading up into a scene or coming out of a scene, that's kind of when we like to just have some fun and banter. And see what sticks, essentially. But Helena is just so out there. And that stuff that Helena Tat comes up with in improv is just incredible and so much fun to play with and so full of energy. It's never a boring day at work, that's for sure.
Now that you've been doing this for a while, have you contributed to build a relationship with the writer's room and stuff like that, to be able to do a loop back for where you or the characters or the relationships are going? Or has it mostly been on the improv front?
I just try to get the writers drunk and then spilling secrets. No, I'm joking. The great thing about this show, which I haven't experienced on other shows, is that it's really a writer's medium for us, and the writers are really highly respected. And every time we're filming an episode, the writer will be there right next to the director every day we're on set for that episode, for their episode. And I've seen the directors turn to the writers and say, is that what you're thinking of with this, you know, with this scene? Does that work for you? And I've seen the writers say, yeah, that's fantastic, thank you. But I was also thinking maybe we could try this angle in the scene. Because there's a million different ways you can shoot a scene. And the directors always respect that. And they're like, okay, we'll do it your way. We'll do it my way. We'll see what happens in the edit. But like, they really take a lot of time to respect the writers and what they want. And having them on set as well is such a good resource as an actor, because if you have a question about the character, or if you don't quite understand why your character is saying this, or if you've got an idea for another line even, you can go right to the director right there and ask them, and they're super receptive to that. And they let us improv, and they trust us with their scenes to let us improv a little bit, which is very, very rare. So it's a huge amount of respect that they give us, that they allow us to do that. But the writers are a really important part of this show, and they're given their due and their respect. And you see it because a lot of our writers get their own TV series, and they're off constantly getting poached to, you know, not poached, they've earned their own series, and they're all, you know, producing them, and it's I'm really proud of our writers, and I'm proud to see them get what's due to them as well. Yeah.
So the actors have a very large input as far as the writing.
In terms of how the story goes, no, I think they do such a good job at coming up with the story, and they, you know, their story editors, the writing room is very strong and quite large. And there's writers that stay on, even though their episode has been written and they're done, they'll stay on for a few more episodes and really continue to work on the story that they set up in their episode. Like, it's a very much a family feeling, you know, in that room, and that's what makes this whole show a really tight family. I don't like to go to them and be like, you know what would be a good idea if Donnie wore more clothes, or, you know. No, I don't try and do that because I really love everything that they come up with. The most I'll do is I'll be like, how are you going to top the twerking scene? I don't think you can top that. And then, you know, you try and, like, reverse psychology to be like, oh, we got to top that. Yeah, let's come up with something. And they do every year. It's like, there's always one or two scenes with Donnie every season that are just, like, mind-blowingly fun, ridiculous, sometimes stupid and wonderful at the same time. And they love challenging us as well. And they don't just have us doing the same thing over and over and over again, which can happen in television. It can be very repetitive sometimes, but they're constantly growing every character. And what's amazing about them is they've got five lead characters played by one actress. That's five storylines right there that are very hard to keep going clearly, but yet we have all these auxiliary characters with each clone, and they do this amazing job of growing all these characters too, and they fit that into 10 episodes every year. It's incredible how good they are at their job, and it's very easy not to notice that because you're just enjoying the story so much, and that's part of the charm of them, is that they can really, really spend so much time with every single character on the show. And we have incredible new characters this season that I think you guys will really get a kick out of.
Awesome. Thank you.
Will you be interacting with those new characters?
There is some interaction with new characters.
Okay.
Yep. And there's even some new Donnie clone pairings that you haven't seen before.
Ooh.
Some really fun ones.